Hey guys, I'm Tyler Alvarez. Thanks for watching Hollywire and make sure to subscribe.
What's up, Hollywire? In the studio with me, I have Tyler Alvarez.
Hey guys.
How's it going?
Good, how are you?
Good. Okay, so you're in a movie, The Pretenders, directed by James Franco.
Yeah.
What was it like being directed by him?
Oh my God, it's really fun. You know, he's such an amazing artist and he's so passionate about everything he does. And it was kind of the first time I'd worked with somebody so passionate before American Vandal. I did that like maybe 4 weeks before I booked Vandal. But I loved it. He's really creative and he makes you feel really comfortable and he's such a actor's director and you could really put yourself in his hands and know that he'll take care of you. And it's really fun.
So take me back to this day. You're on a beach. There's a picture of you, James Franco, and Lana Condor.
Yeah.
What was that? I'm guessing that was the other project that you worked
on. We're working on another project and that was the last day working with James. So we kind of took a little, you know, goodbye photo. It's fun. I love working with him and Lana. She became one of my best friends after doing the movie with her, and she's a sweetheart, and I love her to death.
American Vandal.
Yeah.
Season 2.
Yeah, baby.
Woo! How is this one different from season 1?
It's very different.
Yeah.
No, it's very different. It's we really wanted to up the ante. This crime is really dark and different, and the crime is absolutely incredible. Like, reading it, I honestly had no idea where the story was going. I couldn't, like, last season, I was like, as I was reading, I was trying to figure out who did it. And this time when I was reading, I really couldn't figure out anything. So we see Peter and Sam solving a new crime in a new school, in a Catholic high school, St. Bernardine, where somebody is terrorizing the students with poop. And someone tainted the school lemonade, causing everyone to poop uncontrollably. So of course, Peter and Sam gotta get to the bottom of it. So it's a really crazy, crazy crime with high stakes.
So what was working with Ludacris like?
Oh my God, yeah.
And John Henry?
Oh, he's great, you know. He's really humble and nice and he makes everyone feel comfortable. Like, first day on set, he comes up to me, shakes my hand and introduces himself. And I'm like, you know, this small fish in this big sea, and here's Ludacris like saying hi to me and welcoming me. So it's nice. It's always nice when the big actors make you feel comfortable.
Yeah.
And that's something I learned from one of my other castmates, Paola and Dino. When I was filming my Nickelodeon show, she was the lead and she made everybody feel really comfortable on set from day one. And that's something that it taught me, that I always want to make sure that everybody who comes onto our show, you know, whether a guest star, whether they have one line, just to make them feel comfortable, because we're all here together making the same thing and we're all going to do a better job the more comfortable and the more fun we're having.
Yeah.
So that's something I learned from him and from a lot of other actors I've worked with.
I love that.
Yeah.
And does he introduce himself as Ludacris or Luda?
No, his real name.
Okay.
Bridges got. I know him as Ludacris.
Right? We all know.
Chris, I forgot his Chris. Okay, Chris. Yeah, he introduced himself as Chris. So not Ludacris. Everyone else on the set called him Ludacris.
Right.
But you know.
Did you call him Chris or Ludacris?
Chris.
Nice.
Yeah. I didn't want to look like I was fanboying, but I was a little bit. You know. Ludacris, come on.
Yeah.
The guy's, you know, he's great.
So I saw this, I think it might be kind of old, but this video of you learning how to whistle.
Oh God.
Do you know how to whistle now?
I can do the...
Do it.
Yeah, that all that comes out is air.
Oh, okay.
I can't. Wait, do you know how to do it? Can you show me?
I don't know. I used to be able to do this one. So you put like the tips of your fingernails together.
Okay.
Curl your tongue back.
Okay, this is not working.
It's hard.
I could do this. That's about it.
We are gonna play
a quick game
together. Would you rather?
Okay.
Would you rather be Benny from Orange is the New Black or Declan River from The Fosters for a whole month?
Benny. Benny, definitely.
Would you rather be roommates with James Franco or Ludacris?
James Franco. He's really artistic.
Oh, okay.
So we really vibe with each other and I could learn a lot from the kid. Guy.
Nice.
Kid.
You're still a kid at heart, James.
Yeah.
Okay. If you could only be in TV shows or movies for the rest of your life.
Movies.
Movies.
100%.
If you could, or would you rather see into your future or the future of anyone else?
because I don't want to know how it ends. So I'm going to go with the safe choice of seeing into other people's lives. That way I could help them in some way, maybe.
Sure.
Help guide them.
Okay, would you rather be the vandal or catch the vandal on American Vandal?
Oh, that's kind of, I kind of want to be the vandal.
I know. Right?
I mean, I love solving crimes and it's really fun.
Yeah.
And I would never give Peter up for anything, but being the vandal would be a lot of fun. Yeah.
I guess it would be kind of nice to be like, I am the turd burglar.
Yeah. I'm the turd burglar. Come and find me.
This has been so much fun.
Thank you so much.
Guys, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and we'll see you next time.